Hello, welcome back. This is going to be the start of episode 2 for our Sunstriders game. Unfortunately, my computer decided to not record the opening part of our most recent session. So I'm going to do a little bit of a verbal recap because it has some pretty important lead up to the part that we do have recorded, which fortunately is some very good stuff, which I'm very happy we have recorded. Last we left off, the group was en route to Coronet City on Corellia at behest of Pasita, Ross's uncle, to go help out a small city block called the Duracrete Block in the Forgotten Undercity underneath Coronet City. Apparently, a lieutenant of a gang known as the Hidden Hand has been running rampant, and the Corsec, the Corellian Security Company, has turned a blind eye to the pleas of the civilians. Pasita decided that he would go and help, and the group decided that they would tag along upon payment or recompense from Pasita. Upon arriving on Coronet City, they did a little bit of information gathering, met up with their original employer, or Pasita's original employer, and found out from his child that he had not come home from work a few days prior. Upon running into a crew of gangsters looking for something to do, roughing up passersby for credits, they learn that Stromrok, the lieutenant of the Hidden Hand, has apparently been kidnapping people and forcing them to work underneath the old Duracrete factory. Whispers abound that perhaps a old Clone Wars era droid factory exists deep underneath the Duracrete factory, and that Stromrok is using these civilians as labor to uncover it from rubble and get it back in working order. The group makes quick work of these thugs, getting that information out of them before deciding to head in post-haste and see if they can do something about this situation. Joom, our resident party face, has some ties to the Hidden Hand. Using said ties, he's able to trick Stromrok's majordomo into a personal meeting. Stromrok sees him with a little bit of tense RP and a few lucky checks. Stromrok just thinks that Joom is here on behalf of the Hidden Hand and is coming to collect their piece of the pie, if you will. They head into the factory and see that it is, in fact, the makings of an old droid factory, an old battle droid factory, and is getting very close to being complete. Dak'linn is immediately put off by this. Having grown up and seen the horrors of the Clone Wars, knows that Stromrok, already nefarious, cannot have access to a power such as this. Also, they see Pasita's original employer, Crew Anda, an elderly Duros gentleman, along with 14 other civilians currently working to clear the debris underneath the watch of armed guards. A fight obviously breaks out, and after a lot of tough struggle, the group was able to defeat Stromrok in combat, but not before some of the battle droids were activated. Pasita did a great job of saving most of the civilians, evacuating most of the civilians. Two of them, unfortunately, lost their lives in a volley of blaster fire from some of the battle droids. With the defeat of Stromrok, as one of his final actions, He triggered a bomb of sorts, causing a collapse of the factory. Joom was able to shut down the droids as Dak'linn and Pacit had joined together in the Force, creating an impenetrable wall with their sabers that no blaster shots were able to pierce. With hardly seconds to spare, the group was able to flee deeper into the forgotten underbelly of Coronet City, safe from danger for now. As the adrenaline began to wear off, troubling thoughts began to creep into the group. Raz had realized how easy it was to take a life after he had cut down an enemy in a single swipe of Dak'linn's saber. Even though Stromrok had been defeated, Joom made the decision to ensure the job was finished by placing a single blaster bolt in between the Dwutan's eyes. Nox believed that surely Stromrok's life couldn't be left up to chance. After all, at the end of the day, he was an evil person. Dak'linn saw his younger self in all of his students' thoughts, and decided to share his own personal failings in hopes of getting the learners back on the right track. After safely returning to Coronet proper, it was time for Uncle Pacita to depart. An old friend had arrived to pay back a debt, and he was able to pass along 1,600 credits to our group for their troubles. Raz pulled an old prize fight poster from his jacket, featuring Pacita front and center, and told his uncle to hold on to it as a promise that he and Raz would meet again. With the majority of the group severely wounded from their fight with Stromrok, they sought out a proper med center and paid for a week's stay in a bacta tank. Joom, however, was relatively unscathed and decided to return to the Durakrete block and ensure Crew Anda, their original employer for the Stromrok job, had made it back home to his children. Joom decided it was best to let Boss Crag of the Hidden Hand come to him or inquire about the fall of Stromrok, rather than Joom bringing it to his doorstep. After everyone was healed, Raz decided to continue being the legal front for the party and obtain his bounty hunter's license, now that they could afford to do so. With their newfound legality, Raz decided to look up Nox in the bounty database, discovering he had a bounty, and it was worth about 4,500 credits, and was placed by someone by the name of J. Killian. Meanwhile, Nox was pulled into a Force vision while shopping, a brief flash of Jax Killian in different armor, talking to someone just out of view. It was a voice that was familiar to him, but he couldn't quite place it, and around Jax's boots was the same yellow, rotten-looking sludge from the space station in the Krakul system. Dak'linn decides it's time to do something about the corrupted crystals after everyone rejoins the group. And in your trance, you can see the tendrils of the Force lash out from these crystals and just attach to your body and just have you writhing, just static, locked, connected. The visions grow stronger. They last longer. And every time they end now with these figures returning, the end of them kneeling before long robes and a pair of boots. You can't see above the knee. Seems like there might be some sort of throne or something behind them. But they're returning with banners. They're returning with medals. They're returning with mementos of their excursions, of their victories. And you continue to see more and more. And all three of you, as they happen, the blades get darker and darker and darker. And they start to lose their color. And then the final time you see them turned on, they're just the starkest, like, blood red. And they seem to thrum and jump with excitement as they come out of their hilt. Dak'linn?
A Force. The will of the Force is life, natural life, going against the Force, destroying, killing, hurting. These are a cancer in the Force. And while many atrocities have been committed, using these tools in front of you, while you may not be able to do anything for the people and the beings that have been slain and cut down, tortured and genocided, by these tools, you can use them to promote peace and life and freedom. Listen to the Force. Let the Force use you.
Dak'linn, go ahead and roll a discipline check for, with your Force die. To be a red and two purples.
Hey.
Ooh.
I love those three light side pips, baby.
Total wash with three light sides. You want to use all three?
Absolutely.
That is pretty nutty.
Doubt creeps in. Or tries to. Just the whispering of what if I can't teach these guys? And it's just evaporated, blown away by just peace, prosperity, the hope of a bright future, sheds it away like a fucking Kamehameha to a main villain at the end of a DBZ. And you three respond involuntarily. You regain control. You guys open your eyes back up, and the crystals are in your palms. Fingers wrapped around them. You can feel them. Tendrils no longer attached to you, but you attached the crystals. The harrowing is still there, however. Nox. A familiar hand holds an angry red blade. It's your hand. Jax, missing an arm, is laid in a mud pool, blasterless, helmetless, defeated. And he is attempting to crawl away. Pushing his feet back, pushing his boots back, everything trying to get away. The scene flashes. You're in an unfamiliar place. The body you're in is not your own. It's a human body. They're high above the clouds somewhere on a planet you're not familiar with. They're in a room. There are a lot of beings that look like Dak'linn. Robe-wise, they're familiar. And they're all speaking, congratulating this body on their advancement to Padawan, rank that you've heard once or twice before. A blade constructed, a blade made new. And it flashes back between them rising up in a salute and your hand rising up angry above Jax's prone body. June. Stromrok is laid defenseless before you. A building crumbles around your body. You can hear the faint whisper of friends behind you, but you can't quite make anything out. There is no blaster in your hand. There is an angry blade. And it points at him, right at his chest. There's a flash, a flicker. Your sister, your mother, tied up, cast at the feet of a throne. A familiar tablecloth, a familiar bedspread, a familiar blanket, with a saber rolled up inside of it, a familiar one, a curved one, one that you know spits an orange blade. and is rolled out as an offering to a familiar pair of boots. Raj, there's a clash. Green meets red over and over. A river flows unstoppingly beneath you. Tree branches give way as you leap, bounding after each other one at a time. You can't hear anything. The rapids too loud. The only thing you can feel is the clash of murderous intent. At the final meeting of these two blades, you're transported to a hangar. Fire surrounds you. Ships crash and burn. The sound of turbo lasers go off just outside of a hangar leg, a hangar bay lock. Your uncle lies there unconscious, surrounded by these licking flames. A blade, not apparent, but you hear one coming. Need everybody to make a discipline check. And I think this is going to be, this is probably how this best works.
It's Holy
gonna be
shit.
A red and two purples for all of you.
I would like an extra die.
Go ahead.
Can I, is it a green, I guess? Since I have a yellow already.
So yeah, it'll be a green.
Okay.
And automatic
also,
success.
You will have two automatic successes.
Okay. And you said it was, again, a red and a purple?
Red and two purples.
Two purples. Okay. Well, here it goes. Oh, thank God.
Stay there.
Holy shit.
Ooh, that force point got me an extra, but I didn't actually roll any failures.
Let's see it, Raz.
Oh, can you see Raz's, Chris?
Yes, Raz did roll.
Oh, yeah, refresh. Oh, no.
Yeah.
He made it.
Oh, thank God, dude. Okay, I see it.
Whew.
We're not out of the woods yet, but we're making progress.
Let me tell you, this is damn good progress right here. That's a lot of fucking successes. And the only one close without the help is Raj, and that's a split. Everybody else just succeeded without the help. Jesus.
Sheesh.
Oh, you're not really shasty.
Okay. Well, boys, I've got good news. Or, Dak'linn, go ahead. You have anything else you want to go another round?
Do I want to go another round?
Unless you have anything left unspoken you want to say real quick before we get to the point of no return, if you will?
Nah, I think I think we'll
let me do
we'll
some math real quick.
Also, Jake, question.
Yeah, go ahead.
Can I vigilance a crate of spare parts?
I got you.
Okay.
already had it covered.
Okay, cool.
Hey, look at all this shit that we need. I just happen to have this box of lens emitters and power packs.
Hey.
Worry not. Force provides. Say.
Ooh.
That is 10 collective threat, gentlemen.
Which means nothing.
That's right. It doesn't mean a thing.
God.
Except.
Oh.
An inkling of an eye. Your hands burn. You can see your veins, your finger bones, your palm through the light being emitted from the crystal. Like putting a flashlight through your through like your leg or whatever. You three look up, elevated even higher. You find yourself in the base of a tree somewhere far, far away. There's a tablet there that looks very familiar, or a table, stone table that looks very familiar. You see Dak'linn, who looks in much better shape and a lot younger. Not by much. He just doesn't have as much gray. His hair hasn't thinned as much. And Roz, you would see Noxilus is there. Osic is there. Words go spoken that you don't understand or are made to not be able to hear. And sabers are ignited. A brief clash. Eventually, you see Osic yield. Turns his saber off and surrenders. You see Dak'linn stride forward and cut him down without a second thought. He collects the saber and strides away up a staircase. You three are alone. The presence that you've felt this entire time is gone. Dak'linn is no longer with you. You are in a throne room. And there is a tall-backed, stone-carved throne sitting atop a clear, transparent steel walkway deep somewhere in space. And a figure with familiar boots sits on it. Interested.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute.
Garb familiar. You've seen almost a spitting image of this figure a few hours ago.
Yeah.
Slight changes. A little bit more regalious. A little bit more flair.
Greg, right?
The likeness of.
You may call me High Reclaimant.
And we saw, wait, just to be clear, we saw Dak'linn walk up to him and place a saber there?
No, this was Osic. You saw Dak'linn kill after he surrendered.
Yes, but I thought we saw him walk up the stairs into the throne room, did we not?
No, you were transported separately.
Okay.
So Dak'linn,
I saw in my vision a saber.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Correct.
Okay. Well.
And now you've like seen the truth of your master.
Perhaps, but not the whole truth. Only a fraction.
I assure you, every time I see it, it feels as real as when it happened to me.
Not so much.
You?
In a form. I have no use for that name. That was bestowed upon me by a small-minded master who failed. I serve no master but the Force. I give you that option as well. These crystals I made, I constructed for you. Bled for you. And you can take them. Turn them into weapons. And I will show you a path to true power. Undeniable power. The power to save an uncle. The power to save family. And the power to strike down those you hate the most.
Including the defenseless?
No one's defenseless.
Dak'linn once told me that we have to be better. I'm gonna follow that advice.
He leans forward, knees on the side of his throne. Then you will be tested. And I assure you, you will be found wanting. And the scene blows away in the wind, the last thing left, just the visage of the High Reclaimant on the throne, for he too crumbles into ash, and you three are back in the hole of the Justicar with crystals in your hands.
You all saw that too, right?
Indeed. Dak'linn. What happened in the tree?
I failed.
He did what he thought was right at the time.
Which counts for nothing in the end.
What did he do to set himself down that path?
He did what he thought was right. A life for a life is not the way of the Force. It's not the will of the Force. When Osick made that choice, he became Noxilis.
So it wasn't his death that made him Noxilis, it was his choice.
It was.
I think we'll be seeing him again soon. Probably sooner than we'd like.
Then we must prepare.
How do we start?
Jake is,
Look down. Probably a great first step. Your hands are still gripped impossibly tight around crystals.
Can I open?
You can. All three of you can. There is no hint of red anywhere in the ship. At least not in this hold.
Yeah.
So let me pull up my color wheel real quick, and there's a few ways we can do this.
Oh baby.
If you
you already know you gotta get that thing
in love with a color that you absolutely want for your character, I won't make you not use it.
Okay.
If you want to leave it up to the force, we can always do that.
Give it to the force.
Johanna stole my lightsaber. Where's my lightsaber?
I got my lightsaber right here, baby.
Easy fucking money, dude.
Hey. Okay. Garrett. When you said not the whole truth.
I was thinking about that fucking table scene with Dak'linn and Nox, like, that whole time.
Oh, hooey.
Oh, fuck.
So let's see here. Perfect. Oof. So, let's go ahead. We'll roll d20s, I think. We can either do it an average. So if you want to roll a d20 three times, take the average. Or if you just want to fucking roll that son of a bitch once and see.
What is it? How does it work?
There's a color wheel that I've randomly selected. The first roll will be for the base color. The second, which I'll describe in a little bit, will go off of your morality
Shades.
And hue.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay. Is this a Star Wars RPG?
Nope. This has been a custom creation I've done for a long time. Yeah.
All right. Let me tell you.
It's satisfying, boys. It is.
Man.
All right. Raz, one, Raz, seven. Okay.
Okay.
Did Dak'linn do this?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh,
that's how I got him. Boy.
That's awesome. Such a good color for him as well.
Oh, hey, I'm not telling anybody until you turn your blade on. So I'm doing the math right now, but you guys will still have to construct your shit to know. Ooh, 19. Okay.
Okay.
Oh my god.
We need to run these bitches right now. Y'all rolling my dice.
I will say the crystals as of right now are white. So whenever you physically look down at them, they're just cleansed. So while you are connected to them, they have not revealed your force connection and therefore, as we do, your color yet. Now, you hear a little beeping, charming from up top from R6.
R6.
He tells you guys to come look at this.
Oh no.
Everyone squeeze onto the elevator.
On the lift.
Yeah.
one trip. Come on.
So, you guys are not where you stopped. There is some form of wreckage drifting. It's not one that you've ever seen before, or anything that even looks relatively familiar. If you'd like, you can make a lore check. It'll be a pretty steep one.
I'll do it. Oh, shot.
I got a rank in lore.
Yeah.
I have four dice in lore.
It can be a group check, yeah.
So Chris, if you want to roll it with your rank.
Alright. What's the difficulty?
And it is gonna be 4 purple.
Ooh. Hey, drop a destiny point.
Hey. You ain't gotta tell me twice.
Because that's just how I am.
Damn.
Okay, Dak'linn, I will say this. So with a wash, it's not a success. You could place it about just with, like, it looks like the spire of, like, a space station, right? Mm-hmm. Like a major part had broken off. It looks about 400 years old, architecture-wise, you can kind of place. Other than that, I don't know.
Okay. Any feelings from this?
Reach out and find out.
Hey, I reach out. Oh.
Fuck around.
Reach a little
further.
You know, I think I'm going to let it be. I don't want to taint.
I like that.
What we have here.
Okay. I like that.
R6 lets you know that there is a apparently atmosphere still inside.
So when you say wreckage, is it just derelict, not necessarily broken into bits?
It looks like it was sheared off by something.
Okay.
So like from here, it is a massive piece of station.
Okay.
And it looks like a pretty clean cut.
Okay.
Well, hey, do we
check it out?
I think now's a good time to go check something like this out.
I agree. Not believe in coincidences.
What was it? Is in my experience, there's no such thing as luck.
So Roz and R6 bring you guys in. Hangar is obviously derelict. Nothing really going on. Only emergency lights. You'll definitely need flashlights. Torches.
Paper, perhaps.
So, which you guys are on a starship? You have atmospheres. Human breathable. So it's good for all of you. Forget what it's called. What is it? Hydrogen. Yeah, how they describe it. But breathable for all four of you.
Oxygen rich.
Oxygen rich and like okay. What's the other one in the air?
What it is? Nitrogen.
Nitrogen as well, I think, right? But regardless, there is a plaque above the what looks like a in the emergency lights are on. So it looks like at one point in time, power opened up all the doors. So above the main exit from the hangar door, there is a massive, very looks well-made metal plate. Go ahead.
Type 1 atmosphere.
Type 1
is,
atmosphere. Yeah. Okay.
It's 1, 2, 3, 4, respective to how much gear you need to...
Okay.
Type 1, no gear.
The plaque reads, "Welcome to Starlight Beacon."
Starlight Beacon. Okay.
Want to explore?
Yeah.
What are our paths?
Well, did our ship sensors, are they able to detect life?
Yes, they are. Wouldn't have pinged anything. As okay. a preliminary check.
Okay.
So, well, there is one exit, the main exit. It puts you into... It looks like it was made for civilian use. So, a lot of these immediately big sweeping hallways. Easy stuff. But as soon as you guys walk out of the door, the emergency lights splay over a figure. A statue.
No, bro. Oh, okay.
Yeah. The same guy.
And it's a big one. Hallways are probably 25 foot tall. This statue reaches all the way up to where it starts sloping.
Nice.
It...
Please tell me you have a picture, dude.
I do.
Oh, God,
you
I love
know
that.
He does, my boy.
I love that. That's my DM. That's my guy.
Oh, fuck the DM right there. Now, so let's see.
I don't think I have a picture of a statue. But I don't think I need one, because they're kind of, it's kind of raw anyway.
Oh, baby.
Oh, this is perfect. Oh. Sometimes they just line up. So, the statue has a plaque on it as well. The plaque at the bottom reads Avar Chris as a name. And it looks like that. Plated in bronze.
Ooh. Ooh.
And it's the same pose, like correct. With the
exact,
lightsaber on.
That's
super hype.
Spitting yeah. image, just cast in bronze.
Love to hear it.
So under Avar Chris, it reads Jedi Marshal as a title.
Oh, wait. We're on a Jedi.
Wow.
Oh, it would seem.
Station.
Anything else under that?
That's
or just Jedi Marshal?
Jedi Marshal.
No other, like, not a lot of other statues around. This is the only
one
we've seen so far.
No, this seems to be the only one, yeah.
Okay.
No, like, in loving memory or in remembrance of or anything?
Okay.
I'd like to do a lore check on that.
Go ahead.
What is a Jedi Marshal? What would that...
Go ahead, give me a,
You know, we scoured the records on the Dantooine Enclave.
This is true.
You know?
Give me a hard check. Take two boost dice for your lore check.
Yep. Oh, hate that.
Ooh, oh, three advantage. Three advantage.
That's a fuckload of advantages.
That's a lot of advantages. Which is, I'm willing to give you something for that. So, you don't know the name. You do know that... By the time the fall of the Republic came around, Marshal was no longer a title used by the Jedi Order. So
Sold.
You would assume that it probably had fallen out of order or fallen out of use about the same time that probably this station crashed or was destroyed. The slash effectively cuts off one way of your walking, so you guys obviously go the other way. Having to weave your way through the station, it definitely looks like it was an outpost. It had probably civilian uses, as it has like little signs that point which way to go. And it shows... says civilian, you know, cafeteria, civilian quarters, stuff like that. But they point to sections of the ship or station that you can no longer get to.
Okay.
The stuff that you can reach, however, requires, according to signs and things like that, Jedi clearance.
See. So what are some of our options as far as places that we can reach?
You can go through, it looks like a an offloading area, one. There's a calf, otherwise. There is a big auditorium that you guys have to walk through. And they have some, it looks like they probably had some sort of like launch party not too long before it crashed. So they still have like, you know, streamers and stuff like that up now that have collected dust.
I see.
However, one door in particular is still closed. It is sort of has the markings of like the Republic Firebird, which you're familiar with, was used by the Order as well. And it's the last door that you can really get that you guys can access.
Well, let's try to access it.
Doesn't have a panel, but there is a slot in the wall. Circular, definitely purposefully put by the door. That looks like a receptacle of some kind.
How big is this hole?
Probably this big around.
I'd like what, to...
Do we need a droid or something?
Doesn't look like a hydro circuit.
Bend down and shine my little flashlight in there.
It has like markings and definitely looks purposefully etched. No electrical marking.
I'm gonna take a stab in the dark here. I'm gonna put my lightsaber hilt up to it and turn that bitch on.
So before you can even activate it.
Uh-oh.
Your lightsaber is sucked into the wall. Just deep enough to where the curve of the hilt is barely sitting out. And you can see the orange color of your blade flow through the trim of the door all the way around, complete a circuit, and it slides open quietly.
That's fucking sick.
The Jedi old had pretty fancy technology.
I definitely thought that was a hole to outer space, and he almost just vacuum lost his sword out of the fucking station for a moment.
I've never seen a lightsaber here.
I've never seen anything like this. It's incredible.
That's awesome.
Does it come back out? Or does
as soon as the door opens, the light retracts back to the saber, and you can pull it out.
Okay, I do that.
Very cool.
Very quickly.
And with that, as you guys step in, lights just on. You guys walk in. You are in what looks like combination council chambers, training area, quarters for Jedi that may have been stationed here once upon a time.
Are we gonna, like, go through his stuff?
Oh, his? This is, like, fits, like, 24 people. You are in a massive chamber.
We're gonna go through
chamber.
Their stuff.
Yes, we are.
I think we need to, yeah.
Yes, we are. Oh, God, dude.
I dig into the first...
So, first things first, you are in, like, it spits you out pretty much effectively right into, like, a training area. So they have dummies and things like that that are stood up, as well as training equipment, which, time period accurate, looks about 400 years old. Have blast helmets, just like you guys used. They have staffs, what look like training swords that very similarly resemble lightsabers. They have, like, sort of the sparring gear as well, like padding, for all shapes and sizes. And right there on the middle of, like, the mat is, like, that huge Jedi Order Firebird insignia just blazoned into it.
Fucking dojo.
Yeah, it looks exactly like that, yeah. Through there, it sort of narrows off, and past there, another door there, which you can assume opens up whenever you guys walk in as well. Looking through from where you are, looks like an actual council chamber. Has little room, three chairs of differing sizes that sort of face each other, as well as a big holo projector in the middle. On one wing, looks like the actual quarters, looks like communal living. Foot lockers on the end of beds, very Spartan cots, nothing crazy. Then on the other side, seems to be a workshop.
Hello, workshop.
Any computer terminals?
Workshop.
Hello, workshop.
There is a computer terminal in the council chamber.
Okay. I'll follow the workshop first, but...
Yeah.
I want to take a look at that afterwards.
Activate a few droids, you know?
Yeah. Also, whenever you say training swords, are you talking about, like, the... I'm thinking of, like, the Swator fucking...
training swords, yeah. Uh-huh.
Okay. Yep. Fuck yeah, dude. You're gonna be scooping a couple of those.
Oh, yeah.
For the next part of your training?
For you.
Oh, I see.
Because you guys don't know how to use a lightsaber. Believe it or not.
I can claim...
Full power you, is the best way to
I mean...
I can hit a baseball.
That's what I learn on the job, you know.
Yeah. On the job training.
Put that shit on my resume.
Alright. So, the workshop. Looks like the Knights of the Old Republic workshop. Like the video game. Got a couple of benches. A lot of spare parts. A lot of everything. Now, I mean... Knowing Jedi, they don't exactly, you know, work on tons of pieces. They only have one real tech that they carry all the time. And that becomes very apparent as you guys, like, pull drawers out, open up boxes, and it's just, like, stacks of lens emitters, stacks of power coils, stacks of just the trappings you would need to make or replace a lightsaber.
That's awesome. Ooh. Let's go.
Does it look like there's anything to hold the crystal?
Oh, yeah. No, yeah.
June would just start digging through, yeah.
Yes, we each pick a bench.
Yeah, I would say there's probably four benches, so, you know, take a little seat. Also,
Jacob.
Yeah.
Is there room for improvement?
I don't know if you have any space left on yours. I think we maxed yours out a long time ago.
I don't think I do, but yeah, that's true.
Because you have superior on yours, you have the curved hilt. I don't think you have any hard points left.
No, probably not.
And you have 2 damage? Yeah, there's no chance we have anything left for you, I don't think.
I'm only 8 damage.
8 damage, that's right.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
Holy.
I'll go ahead and send this in the chat to you again. Quick. We'll need it.
Oh, wait. Is this going to be a...
These are the types that you can build, yes.
Let's go. Let's go. I didn't see it, though. Is it in there?
I just put in character creation. Ignore the top three. Ignore the exotic plasma weapons.
Oh.
It'll be in the...
Lightsaber
hilt.
Okay. Do they have pictures attached?
Oh, man.
They can look like whatever you want them to look like.
Oh, okay.
But if you have questions,
the stats are different. Okay.
Yeah, the stats will change per. Yeah. Also, make sure you look at the hilt one because it the crystal I have is statted versus the normal one. So we'll do that and just.
The light foil.
Yeah, you should have made one of those back.
I should have. Yeah, literally alongside the Makashi form.
Would have been killer.
Crazy.
The broad saber. Oh god.
Yeah, buddy.
So I just have... I actually want to recreate my shit at some point. Like...
Some point.
Well, like
I think
right
this
now.
Is the point, yeah.
I think now might be the time.
So we had Dantooine crystals?
Yeah.
Right.
Those were custom creations. So.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I'm that guy, you know.
Not Dantari crystals?
No. Okay. I don't think at least. I'm pretty sure that. Yeah, no, they were. Sorry. Oh, wait. Yeah, they were.
Oh, wow.
Good eye. I forgot about that.
Oh, using the force is more calming. Cool.
Man. Tough call.
Yeah, it always is.
Yeah, crit rating -1, damage +2. Yeah, that would be it.
We're going with the cross guard.
Ooh. So, fun fact, that would be very easily findable because they were still very popular when this station was active. So they have template guides for them and everything. So
it was between that or the Great Saber.
Yeah.
I gotta go with the cross guard.
Yeah. Now, food for thought, is it going to be like, so one of the guys in the High Republic books, his prongs slide pop out of his saber when he turns it on, and like he has like the metal part of it as well, like on top, like under the blade, or is it just gonna be like Kylo's that just shoots him out of the fucking side? I'll leave that up to you. I'll let you think.
I was thinking the Kylo's shooting out the sides.
Hell yeah.
Maybe like a small like guard on the top of the handle where like the energy shoots out right on top of it.
Perfect. Hey, you're the one making it.
Oh yeah. No, I'm going to find a picture.
I just need the stat recreation as well to make sure you guys are right. Dom, nah, I don't know what you've decided, but I'm just going to toss it out there. Have high enough agility to use a double blade if you want to. Just...
I was thinking light fall.
Hell yeah, you can do that too.
Oh-wee.
I want the defensive.
Oh, it does have defense.
Is my athletics high enough?
So Three. It's actually agility.
I think it's the same stat, right?
No, athletics goes off brawn.
What's agility?
Agility, the main stat.
Where do I see that?
It's your main stat. Like your characteristic agility.
I think the Nautilans start with 3.
No, I only have 2. Damn.
If you have 3 brawn, you can use the lightsaber pike as well as the great saber.
No, but I would have to go off. I need something that goes off of intellect eventually.
So don't worry about that, because that comes with lightsaber forms, which we'll get to eventually.
Oh, okay.
So build whatever you fucking want. I will say the stock art for Arbiter has a pike, Noah. So if you want to, I'll look it up quick.
I'm looking at him right now on my other screen. Those are sick.
I think, didn't Pacita have one?
Originally? I think you guys had all regulars. I don't remember.
Yeah, it was.
I wouldn't mind the pike, but could I have the retractable hilt so I could have it as a saber if I ever wanted to? Or is that game-breakingly busted?
No, but so for so to whenever, because it does take a check to actually build your sabers.
Is it a mechanics check?
There are a few things we can do. And there are ways to spend in your spend advantages and triumphs that can give you stuff like that. So yeah.
I see. Okay. Because I've got pretty good building shit abilities. What's a broad saber?
It's like a sword. Instead of a cylindrical beam, it has a flat edge to it, like a real sword.
That's awesome.
Yeah, it's if you watched Ronin, the Visions episode, he has one. Because it's a katana as a lightsaber.
Yes, I did watch that one.
That one goes so stupid.
It does go insane. Yeah, that's probably going to be the one, I think.
Which one?
The broad saber.
Okay.
That's fucking disgusting.
Now, to start with the base, it does have unwieldy.
Okay, what does that mean for me?
That means your agility is 1 short of what you need base.
Oh, to use it.
With the build, if you get advantages, you can drop it down.
For the pike?
No,
for the broad saber. It looks so cool.
So, just so you know, with 2 advantages, Noah, you can swap it. You can install what
drop
they call
down
a counterweight. It trades out unwieldy for cumbersome, and then which is brawn, which means you'd be able to.
Holy shit!
Okay, so and I assume if I can't do that, it'll just end up being something different.
Oh yeah, sure.
Is that right? Yeah, I won't end up with a sword I can't wield.
So you can use them. It just increases the difficulty of your check.
Of the checks. Oh, okay.
So you're never able to not turn it on or whatever.
Okay. All right. Well, fair enough. Let me see. I don't want to hold everybody up. So go ahead and begin.
Oh, you're good.
But yeah. Keep looking. We can go ahead and start. Who wants to go first?
I will.
All right. And we are going with the broad saber. Wait, what were we going with?
I have the crossguard.
Crossguard, that's right.
And crossguard can be one-handed, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's what I'm thinking. Yep. Perfect.
Yes, it can. Now, Dak'linn, are you going to assist in this? by any means?
Yes, I absolutely will be.
He's got that teacher like pacing from one desk to the next. Yes.
Oh, well, how you doing over here, buddy? You doing okay? No, look, we need to. You're on the right track. You're on the right track. But...
No. The lens emitter goes at the end.
Okay.
So, what is a Shoto lightsaber?
Shoto, they're shorter.
Very short. Yeah.
Shorter.
Ahsoka.
Blade.
Ahsoka uses a Shoto in her offhand.
So what's the agility for dual wielding? Three you need.
Agility, to dual wield, it's just it has no requirement. If they're the same, you only have one crystal at the moment. But if it's the same weapon, so for example, two lightsabers, you just add a dice to the check. So normally so it'd be three purples. And then with two advantages, you can hit with both in the same turn.
Okay,
Garrett, to start, it's going to be... Yeah, go ahead.
Can I do my battle meditation thing again?
No.
Or no? Okay.
Has to be
however,
there must be a limit.
Okay, sick. I love that. Okay.
Hey, what am I rolling?
So, you're going to have two boost die for Dak'linn's help.
Cool.
And for the defensive saber, which is a cross guard, it's going to be a hard check, so three purples, and it's either going to be mechanics, lore, or it can be mechanics, lore, or lightsaber, which I don't think you have yet. So
I actually spent five of that XP on the first rank of lightsaber.
But okay. Well,
either way, it'd be
feel free. If you have it, if you spent the XP,
I'm gonna go with that. I took it as like seeing Roz just completely cut a dude in half. He's like, oh. Okay, so it's pretty, it's simple.
Yeah.
Hot side down,
All right, lightsaber, two boost. And three purple?
Three purples, yeah.
Okay. Boom. Nice.
Okay.
One success,
so
two advantage.
So let me tell you what else you can put on. With two advantages. So, you can make it two-handed, which is going to increase your damage by one and your encumbrance by two, but it would require two hands to wield. And that would just take one advantage. You can also do... you can make it disguised for two advantages, which would add a setback to other people... trying to identify it while it was not ignited.
Okay. So those two options?
Yeah, you have those two and lightweight, which just reduces the encumbrance, which is also one.
I think I'll do the hidden one.
Okay, cool.
And disguised.
All righty. Go ahead and write that down. And for your crystal, let me tell you the stats real quick.
I'm so excited for you guys. This is awesome.
Here they are. Okay, so your damage is going to start at 6. Your crit's going to be 2. Your encumbrance... Did you do lightweight?
No, disguised.
Disguised. Okay, your encumbrance is going to be 1. You're going to have 4 hard points.
Yeah.
And you're going to have the attributes are going to be Breach 1, Defensive 1, and Sunder. And Disguise will go under Special as well.
Cool.
Also, whenever you're attacked, you can spend 3 threat to disarm your opponent. So if you're attacked and I have 3 threat, you can disarm them with your crossguard.
Ooh, okay, cool.
Okay, now for the fun part. Modding your crystal.
Overclocking your crystal.
You literally, yes. Now, this is fine-tuning, so this one you can't use your lightsaber skill on.
You want it?
Be lore okay. or mechanics.
Okay. Both of them are 2 greens for me.
Okay, okay.
So I'll probably go mechanics.
Now, the mods, the options you have 2 damage plus 1 options. You have 1 reduce critical option. And that is actually it for you.
Yeah. And so if I picked one and failed, I couldn't try again later, right?
Not without rebuilding your entire lightsaber. Yeah.
Okay. I'll do the crit.
Now, the first one, now for the mods, the first one's just 1 purple, and then they build up from there.
Okay. So. Yeah, I'll do the 1 reduced crit.
Okay. All righty, go ahead and make your check. Destiny points are available.
I will definitely swap one.
Okay.
To upgrade.
You have a yellow, a green,
and 1 purple.
And go ahead and add your force die. This is the fun part. You're dealing with the heart of your saber here. So go ahead and add your force die and 1 purple to start.
Ooh. Oof.
Okay.
I don't need to use the dark side though.
You don't. But you can get rid of both of those threats. Like.
Yeah, I saw.
I will not.
Okay. All right, so your critical is down 1. Do you want to keep going?
No. I think I'll stop there.
Okay, so your damage will be at 6 for now until you ready to go. So, this is going to take you 15 hours. Next. So, this is going to be... Yeah, who wants to go next?
I have an idea for mine.
Okay. Oh, who wants to roll next? It doesn't matter either way.
If you don't want it, I'll take it right now.
Yeah, go for it. Go
okay.
for it.
Dom, let's
light foil.
Light foil. Okay. I actually have never seen a light foil in one of my games yet. So this is fun. Now, these look like the coolest thing about them is that they're
rapiers.
They look like rapiers, but they look like A New Hope lightsabers. How they were like super. They look like the Rebels lightsabers. They're super thin, really long blades. Fun shit.
I like the idea of a kind of like crescent moon hilt, because some of them are kind of like overdoing it a bit, because they do have a bit of a handguard over the hilt that's usually just like weaved wired metal.
Yeah.
And like that probably being low profile, and then a crescent moon kind of like over the knuckle.
Fuck yeah. Okay, cool. Sweet. Alrighty, so first things first, lore, mechanics, or lightsaber to actually build the hilt.
Alright, 3 green.
Okay, and you will have the 2 boost dice as well. Okay. And the light foil actually counts a defensive blade as well. It's going to be 3 purples. Okay, cool, sweet. Hey, wow. Literally exact same results. Okay, so, and with that, just like with Garrett, you have the option of lightweight, two-handed, so you can make your light foil two-handed if you wanted. Those are both 1. Or for 2, you can make it disguised or add a counterweight. Which you can't really add counterweight because you don't have unwieldy. So, no.
And lightweight.
Lightweight would reduce your encumbrance by one, which would make it zero, which means you could effectively hide it anywhere.
I feel like that's almost in the same kind of channel as disguise. I kind of want to go with lightweight.
Disguised though. Gives you the actual setbacks, though.
Makes yeah, it I think having it lightweight, though, and the fact that it is that kind of, like, it is a light pool, double down on it.
Okay. And you have one left over, which means you could make it two-handed for that sweet, sweet extra damage. If you
really is that all it does is the damage yeah. for two-handed?
Gives you one extra damage and then increases your encumbrance. So you'd effectively make it like the, what are the two-handed katanas called? I can't remember. Any local weebs in the chat?
No idea.
No.
Any Dark Souls players in chat?
Nagachi?
Yeah.
Boom. I'm a weeb.
Yeah.
So that's up to you, though. If that, if you
I
need
would,
it to be
if
one
I can, I think I'd like to do that if I can flavor it kind of to be like an Adachi. That
yeah,
shit's
fuck
pretty
yeah. Fuck yeah.
Fucking fire. I just pulled up a picture of one and I was like.
Yeah. So you're, I mean, your hilt's going to be long as fuck. But that's, yeah. Hell yeah. I say long as fuck. It's going to be longer. But yeah, sweet. Okay, cool. So now naturally the light foil actually loses a damage naturally, so mm-hmm. you offset that.
Just base damage.
So
yep.
to start, your damage is going to be 6, crits 2, you have 1 hard point, and you have breach 1, defensive 2, and sunder.
So damage 6, crit 2, sunder, 1 hard point?
1 hard point, yeah.
What else?
And breach 1 in special. Defensive
and
2
defense.
And Sun 2.
Alright, I got all those.
And now.
Jacob?
Yeah.
I'm going to send you the picture of my saber.
Please, God, please. If you find one, please send it to me.
Yes.
That's my favorite fucking part. Okay, and now for the crystal modding. Just like Garrett, you have the exact same thing. You have 2 damage 1 increases and 1 critical decrease by 1.
So wait, what's up?
So to mod your crystal, you can increase the damage twice by 1, and you can decrease how much it takes to crit, so you'll bring your crit rating down to 1 time.
Can I do the crit rating?
You can do that first, yeah. So that'll be something a lore or mechanics, and the first one's just 1 purple, and you do get to add your force die.
Okay, 2 green, 1 purple, 1 white.
Yeah. You want to use it? You can.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that'll give you your success you need for it. So go ahead and drop your critical rating down 1. Which should.
So I just have this like in my boots. I haven't made the weapon, but
yeah,
I am
no
going
to
take the.
Yeah, we can do that whenever you get time. Okay, cool. Do you want to keep going?
What is the consequence if I
so
fail?
So if you fail, it blocks that option off until you rebuild your entire lights.
Yeah, why the fuck not?
Sweet, okay. So next one, so you have the only you have 2 damage plus 1s left, so it doesn't matter whichever one, but it'll be 2 purples for the next.
And my force die?
Yes, sir. You need both of them. All right, go ahead. Pump your damage 1. You want to try for the last one?
You're damn right.
Hell right, yeah, go baby.
Go ahead.
Good lord.
It'll be 3 purples. Gonna happen.
So it was 2 greens, 3 purples, and my force die.
Mm-hmm. I leave this up to you. You could have an 8 damage saber.
Yes.
Just like your. Yes, dude. Yes. Yes, bro.
That's crazy. That's.
Oh,
crazy.
No. My 1 willpower.
It wasn't. Oh, this is going to be so good if I could just finish it. All right.
I think that's enough. Fuck off.
So, okay, yeah. You're going to have 8 damage, and then that's all your mods. So you'll have 8 damage and 1 crit rating.
That's incredible. You have the same lightsaber as me, effectively.
Yeah.
Okay. Ah, oh, shit.
Joom. You ready, dude?
Joom.
I was going to go for the light foil, but that's okay, because I'm going to go for the broad saber
Wait,
now.
Wait, no, you still can. It doesn't even
matter. It's got to be unique.
Okay. But man, it's a lightsaber, it bro.
It's
Ain't
gonna
nobody
be
else
unique.
In the galaxy going to have lightsabers.
It matters to me. Because I'm also just going to do the broad saber. It's fine.
Okay.
Okay.
But I want to flavor it. To...
Oh, baby.
Can I, like, mix? Like, I'll take the lightsaber stats, the common classic lightsaber, but just flavor it to be a broadsaber. Like, the blade style, not the size.
So, you want the regular normal blade, or you want the
flat
blade?
No, I want the stats of a regular lightsaber, right?
But okay,
I just
want to
make that regular lightsaber have
the
blade.
Saber,
yeah, the flavor of the blade. That's what I was really trying to
do. Yeah, no, that's perfectly
fine. Okay, cool. Yeah, that's what I want to try for.
Okay, great. Then we'll just we'll go off the stats of the normal saber then.
And what I want it to be is kind of like a long pointed dagger.
Okay, cool. Do you want to go with the Shoto then? Or like how long blade are we talking?
See, the thing is, the Shoto does 5 damage. I don't like that.
It does 5 damage. Now, also, Breach. Let's remember, Breach cuts through 1 armor. Not 1 soak, 1 armor. Okay. So that's 10 soak. So effectively, you do 5 damage, but it's 5 true damage.
That's true.
So don't let the stats get in the way if what you really want.
What does Accurate do?
Accurate gives you a boost die on every attack.
Every time. Okay.
God, this is fucking awesome.
I fucking love this part.
Yeah,
every time.
So don't let it get away from you. Also, with enough, you have 4 dice for either one of your skills. So that gives you the chance
you can hit
to give you a lot of crazy shit on your build.
I understand.
So
there's always one of them.
Yeah, there's always one person with a crazy cracked out lightsaber.
Maybe we will go Shoto. Yeah, let's do Shoto.
Okay, cool.
Fuck it. I might dual wield later on, too, so that gives me the avenue for that.
Sweet. Great. This a great start. Let it call to you. That's all I got to say.
Okay, we'll do Shoto.
Okay.
And then for that, it's the check is 2 purples?
Let me double check.
I'll use mechanics.
It's going to be because it counts as a precision one.
Okay.
It'll be 2 purples, and you can use lightsaber, lore, or mechanics.
I'll use mechanics.
Okay. And also you have a destiny point available. You get 2 boost die as well from deck.
Okay.
You're welcome.
Let's go for it. Okay. I have 1 advantage on that.
Okay. And with
roll the... 4 threat.
Yeah, I know. That's actually nuts. With 1 advantage. That is, you could lightweight it, but that's about it.
That's fine. I guess I'll lightweight it, sure.
That'll make, 0 encumbrance. It's light as a feather. Stiff as a board.
Hell yeah.
Okay. So, you're going to have 5 damage, 2 crit, 0 encumbrance now. 3 hard points, and you'll have accurate 1, breach 1, and sunder. Hey, this is great. Everybody's done in 12 hours or 15 hours with the mods.
But there's no crystal mods or anything?
Hey, we're going to do those next for you, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, you're still coming up. Are you ready to do that?
Oh, yeah, sure.
Okay, cool. What do you want to do first?
It'll
be the minus crit rating 1, or you have 2 damage plus 1 option.
Oh, damage plus 1.
All right.
Wait, can I do 1 of each? Or I can try
you can
one
do
of
all
each?
3. You can try all 3.
Oh, okay.
It's just
I'll try.
Until you fail. Yeah. What do you want to do?
Let me
because
do
the
crit
first
rating
mod
first.
Is the easiest one, and then so on and so forth. It gets
Let me
harder.
Do the crit rating first, then.
Okay, go ahead. It'll be 1 purple, and you can add your force die.
And that's, again, a mechanics check? Yep. Okay. Okay, and then force die 1 purple, 2 purple.
1 purple to start.
Okay, boost die.
Nope, no boost die here.
Okay. Oh, I use it.
Hey,
instantly. No questions.
Motherfucker.
Let's fucking go.
With four fucking no, I'm not accepting a failure on that roll.
Amen, brother. You don't have to tell me twice.
Not happening. And you know I'm going for more.
All right, next one's two purple.
There
easy
we go.
Easy money.
That's the damage.
Yes,
and then
plus
I go.
One damage. And then last one will
one
be three
more.
Purples.
Oh, fuck.
And you'll need... Oh! Let's go, dude. All right.
Jesus
so you'll have
Christ.
Seven damage, and then your crit rating will be one for the Shota.
Hell yeah.
I love
okay.
it. I love
I need
it
to record that.
I started recording, by the way. Wait, yeah, yeah.
Okay,
yeah,
cool.
So.
But how do I... It should be like a weapons tab somewhere, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, you can make one in RPG sessions.
Perfect.
All righty. So... Dak'linn, are you doing anything?
No, I'm not. I think I'm just gonna... At this point, it's the legacy saber.
Yeah.
Add critical injury.
I'm updating all my trees right now.
Okay.
So.
Now, they do have other mods that you can... put into your sabers that aren't the crystal.
My crit rating is one for that?
Yeah.
Okay.
So depending on how many hard points you have, I'll send that
okay, yeah, that's all I need to know.
Character creation. Because we will do that now as well. While we're here. The show has the foil has only one hard point.
Oh, this is where the curve tilt comes, right?
Correct.
I bet Shoto probably doesn't have any.
The Shoto has, I think, one as well.
Where do you see that?
It should be hard point one. I think I told you. I'm looking it up.
Well, wait. It says increases.
Oh, HP is what it was.
Dueling
right.
ability. That means I. Wait, I forgot. Doesn't that give me... Hold on.
Yes,
I
have
whenever
three
you
hard
fight
points
other
on the
lightsabers, Shoto. It lets you fuck on them. Yeah.
Wait, that's one nuts. Automatic advantage.
Shoto's got three hard points.
Nice.
Wait, I haven't even been doing as much damage as I should have been doing.
That's against other saber users.
It says... Advantage to lightsaber combat checks when engaged with a single opponent.
Oh.
So...
How many
Whenever
times have you been... Oh, well, I guess... No, because you traded your saber. Well.
Yeah. I'm sure there have been instances where it was just one... Like, in the arena with the one giant monster, could have fucked on it even harder.
Mm-hmm.
Not that it matters, but... Can you print... Off like, does RPG sessions have a thing to let you like print a character sheet?
I don't think so. No.
God, that would be so fucking cool.
I think there's an export somewhere. I don't know how to find it though.
Oh wait, yeah, you can do that.
There's just a ton of options.
Yeah.
All right. Okay. So, anybody seen anything that strikes their fancy?
Sorry, I had to check this first.
So superior Dak'linn has, it gives you the free success and advantage in combat.
What is the only one that I see that I think I like? As far as one hard point. We're choosing from anything on the list, huh?
Yep, as long as it fits, yeah.
Yeah, I think I'm going to go with the superior.
Okay. Now, we do have to make some checks, so decide. If you're ready, Dom, we can.
Let's do it.
Okay, so your first hilt mod, not crystal mod, hilt mod, starts as a 3 check.
The force die, or... So it's 2 green, 3 purple?
It would be 3 purple, yeah.
My eyes committer.
Hmm. Do I? Do I want to give the force die out? I'm going to say no.
You
are, at this point, you're 15 hours in. You're going to have to be of your own accord.
Oh, baby.
And grip. Destiny's own accord.
Let's grip.
Let's fucking go. Okay. So you'll have a free success and a free advantage.
Good lord.
And superior personal, superior is like customization. So effectively, you spend the extra time to make it fit your exacting specifications. Your lightsabers are already one of one, but yours now is one of one of one.
Let's fucking go.
I have an idea for mine. Okay. This is about to go crazy if I can pull this off.
Thinking? What you thinking?
So is it the same way the check gets harder after each one?
So
or
the first
matter?
Mod's 3, the second one is 4. Yeah.
Okay. Let me wait. Why is it every time I look at my weapon, it takes me away from the game table? Oh, baby. All right. So I want to do which one's better? It's going to be both of them are going to involve parry.
Okay.
So I want the reflex grip, which improves parrying and reflecting.
Okay.
It's a 2 hard point check.
Mm-hmm. I got it up. Yeah.
And it's the first one is 3, you said?
Yeah, you want to do this one first?
I do want to do this one first.
Okay. Yeah, first one's 3.
Sheesh. Ah, damn it.
Right. You'll have to wait for another time.
For that one, or can I try the other still?
Yeah. Okay. So you still have one hard point available to try today.
Yep. And I would like to do... Where's it at? It's the flicker phase
modification.
Oh,
it's
baby.
The one hard point. No. Oh well.
Oh, yeah. Hey, that one's only 3 still. You still failed. You failed the first one, so it doesn't stack.
Oh.
Right. Yeah.
Fuck. All right. Well, that's even more tense.
Hey, let's go, baby.
Let's go.
Right. Nice.
That's awesome.
Okay. That's now. Success. So with the, I assume you read everything on the flicker phase, right?
Flicker phase makes blade harder to parry is all it says for me.
Oh, if you click that, you gotta open it up for the actual.
Oh, okay.
Body. So yeah, take a peek at that first.
Oh. Okay. Wait a minute. Consider cheating in duel. Unstable, making unpredictable. Most. Oh, it makes it harder to fight with. Oh.
Harder to fight. Oh yeah, and against.
Okay, well maybe not.
So well, yeah, because it does smack your damage down and give you 2 setback dice.
Never mind. I didn't realize that was a okay. My bad.
However, if you fight another saber user, they can't parry that shit. So.
Yeah, I'm okay.
Gotcha.
Maybe come back to me later. I didn't realize that was
okay. Yeah,
I didn't
yeah.
See
keep
that.
Looking. Go ahead. All right. Garrett?
I'm thinking I'm going to go with the damping emitter.
Okay. That is only 1, so you'll still have 3 hard points in the cross
yeah.
guard.
But I can come back. Or, like,
you have every part
later.
Available to you right now.
Right now.
For free. So yes, you can come back in the future, but it will require finding those parts. And you'll notice that the cost for these is pretty high.
Pretty high.
So
yeah.
Keep that in mind.
Okay.
I'm setting you guys up right now. I'm giving you the buffet right now.
Yeah. And I'm guessing we can't choose the different crystal types, just the actual.
Not
saber
yet,
mods.
But if you do want to go a different route with your crystal, you always can. It just turns into having to find one.
For sure. Man, give me a sec.
Yeah, no problem.
God, then I remember sitting down making our lightsabers.
I know, man. Oh, God, it's the best. Noah,
it's just so satisfying.
Yeah, I think I may want to do the walking stick disguise. I don't
ooh,
know.
Ooh, okay. Ooh, Pimp Cane Junes. Hey.
I'm not sure if I like the flavor. Because the Shoto art already starts with accurate one. So inaccurate minus one would just make it neutral.
It doesn't take anything away. It just adds the dice. So you'd be rolling and the black. Yeah.
Oh, maybe the hilt masking kit then.
Yeah.
Okay, Mata. What does this do? Doesn't it give me any negatives?
No negatives.
Okay, yeah, I'll do the hilt masking kit.
What do you want to hide it as? It gives you the option?
Yeah. Honestly, let's just go literally canteen, water bottle.
My Hydro Flask.
Flask. Okay.
Literally, like just a fluid tube.
Okay, cool. Works for me.
That's awesome.
So yeah, go ahead and make your check. It'll be Actually, you already made the check. I'm not gonna make you roll again.
Okay, cool.
Because just the fine print got you. So yeah.
Yeah, I did not realize you could click on them for more info.
Now, do you want to try and mod this as well?
How do you mean?
Because some of the mods have extra mods as well, like the crystals do. So your base modifier gives somebody trying to find your lightsaber 2 automatic failures. You also have 2 extra automatic failures you can try to add.
Potentially, I might as well. And the only consequence is I couldn't try again unless you have to
rebuild the entire thing. Yeah.
And I potentially down the line, let me see the rarity. What's the rarity of this thing that I'm looking for?
Hilt
mask. It's like rarity.
Is only 6. Rarity's not even anything. It's because it's.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So I could do it at any point.
Yeah.
But would I ever have a better chance? Like,
I mean, yeah. Really? Oh, well, better chance? No.
Probably not.
You're in a Jedi stronghold
outpost
with every material around you. It doesn't get much better than this.
Okay. So I'll go ahead and do that. What do I need to roll for the check?
First one is going to be 4 because we have the mod in.
Okay. I won't ruin my original mod if I fail this, right?
Nope.
Okay.
This is all extra stuff.
That's right. That's fair enough.
You still have one left. It will be 5 purples, though. You have one. You might as well give it the
might
other.
As fucking well.
Might as well give it.
Ah! It was close. It was close, but that's okay. Right. I'll take that. I'm happy with it.
Make sure you get your 2 automatic failures for identification down in your notes. Dude, I forget.
Yeah, that I need to do that.
All right, Garrett. What are we feeling?
So, I've only got 2 greens for my mechanics, so I gotta pick the one I want to keep first.
It's true.
I think I'm gonna go. I mean, could I try the superior one first?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I think that makes the most sense. Yeah, I'll do that.
Okay, now. I can offer you a double-bladed sword here. I can upgrade one of these to a red, but give you a yellow so you can spend it back. So, what are you thinking?
I think yes.
All right, let's fucking do it. Go ahead and swap one to a red and swap one to a yellow.
Mechanics. Yellow 2, or like 1 red, 1 purple.
2 purples. 3 check.
Gotcha. Yeah. Alrighty. And yeah, that's it. Let's roll it. Oh my god.
Let's go, dude! Let's fucking go. So you get the free success, free advantage, and that's 1 hard point down. You want to try again?
Oh, fuck. Yep.
Alright, what's you going for?
I think next I'll go for the fusion shunt to give me breach 2 against armor. Let me add superior.
So it does, as a maneuver, you can activate or deactivate your fusion shunt. And then whenever it's active, your combat checks suffer 3 automatic threat, and your breach goes up to 2.
Yeah.
Okay.
Make
sure we read the fine print.
Yeah.
All right. Hey, two greens versus 4 purples. The dream. Let's get her done. We win these.
2 greens, 4 purples. No fall. Two threads.
So close. So technically, how much is the fusion shunt?
2,000.
Oh, so, I mean, so you still have two hard points left. I mean, it's going to be a hard fucking check, but you might as well swing for the fences, right?
Yeah, I mean, might as well. Force guide me.
So, yeah, what else you want to try and slap on?
I'll try the damping emitter to make it stun.
Okay.
So, two greens versus five?
Five purples. Yes,
all right. Here goes nothing. Nah.
Ooh, God.
Ethan, dude, so close. I pulled three successes.
All right, you got one. Two. Hey, you got one hard point left. You want to give one a shot?
Fuck him up.
You're getting so close. It's like the casino. You gotta keep going.
If you succeed this one, I'm mad for you.
All right, then yeah, let's try it.
You could try the extended hilt is one.
I was thinking Thalothian heartwood hilt.
Ooh. You're going for the most expensive one.
Just two success, but four threat gives that.
Now it is going to be house and you order a red tomahawk. And four purples because you can't have any more purple dice than you already do.
Yeah. So. Yeah, why not? Fuck it. Right. Red for purples. God.
And wow, you blank too! Dang, man. All right,
good,
so.
Good God.
Okay, give me just a moment, gentlemen. It's the moment you've all been waiting for.
I love this.
Where's my fucking Spotify?
Sunder, what does that do?
Sunder lets you target equipment and damage it.
Okay.
So, like, if you hit with two advantages, you can sunder, and items go from normal to damaged to broken. So if you sunder something twice, you can break an item.
Okay.
And that's anything. That's even, like, armor that people are wearing and shit like that.
Okay. Saber. Okay, I think. Cost one hard point, rarity zero, cost three, description.
Oh! Eventually, you all slip into a trance as you work, as is required. Dak'linn, what do you do in that time?
I think I do what we said, kind of the teacher walking back and forth from each, you know, just echoing like the Jedi code, echoing, feel the force, let it flow through you type shit.
You have a quick, about 4 hours in, you have a quick flashback to Amma just effectively preaching, filibustering for almost 36 hours, which is how long it took your group to finish their constructions. And after that finishes, about the 4 hour mark, as Amma was reciting Jedi history to you guys, you're like, wow, these guys are coming along a lot faster than we did.
Yeah.
And as everything begins tightening up, eventually it's time. The pieces are in place. You double check everything. And Dak'linn gives you guys the... Yeah, it looks good. Of course, you have to use the Force to align the crystals, which you all did, and... It's the moment of truth. So who wants to be brave and go first?
I will.
All right. So go ahead. Oh, let me open up your DM real quick.
Right.
That motherfucker raw, boy. That is raw. I can put it you in gotta the send that too. In the chat after. Yeah. Yeah. After whenever we finish, if you have a picture, you gotta send that. But... All right, Nox. So. Go ahead and walk us through your, just give us a verbal description of your hilt as you're stepping forward to class project, turn it on.
So, like in the picture, the top part of the hilt has just three openings, like left, top, and right. But kind of past below the button, instead of the like silver, it's more like wrapped leather, kind of like going horizontally down. And then the pommel is kind of the same, like little, just a little ending.
Just like, all right, Nox, as you step forward, mind foggy, heart beating, you thumb the ignition. A pretty much brilliant, or, five is lighter. A brilliant sort of magenta-ish blade erupts first from the top and then sputters out of the sides, flicking kind of like as you're cranking the key in your ignition, and eventually it catches crystal in place and a full beam, thick, emerges bright, casting light from the center of the room.
Nice. Before I even rolled, I was like, I'm thinking a purple lightsaber.
Crazy what the dice make of this dude. I'm saying. And feel so, I can try and send you the exact color. I don't know how it'll work, but feel free if you want a brilliant magenta, if you want to find the one that fits that description to you, feel free.
Yeah, for sure. I might even recolor that photo I sent in.
Oh, sweet. Hell, fuck yeah. All right. Who's next? All right, Roz. After you unmute yourself.
Yeah.
So, my hilt is, I don't say it's curved at all. Really straight. Probably about foot and a half. Maybe a little shorter than a foot and a half long. Very sleek, smooth the whole way down with a sort of like angled cap at the end. Then the piece that the lightsaber juts out of, there's kind of a small like hand guard, like not necessarily rapier, how it comes around. It's just large, kind of around the opening of the lightsaber. And from that point, there's a kind of like metal hand guard, but it's in the shape of a crescent moon that comes to about 3 or 4 inches up the end of the hilt. And it's pretty slim to the hilt and relatively thin.
Hell yeah.
And I would like to turn it on.
As you step forward. Thumb the ignition on, and a thin, long, brilliant aqua green blade extends from your hilt, and it's like even lighter than like a lime green. It's like has a lot of white in it, just very faintly sea foam all the way through.
The family brand.
Yeah, hey. Hey, crazy. Crazy, dog. Zoom.
So, my Shoto hilt. It's black and takes a very rectangular shape. And for the sake of balancing, I have stored the crystal in the butt of the hilt, all the way at the bottom. And the conduits, which bring the power from the saber, from the crystal to the end of the saber, are inladen in the external portions of the hilt. So whenever I ignite it, the color just seeps forward in a whatever color we're about to find out. And it's a very much a dagger hilt. So,
holy shit!
Rum it on. And a golden orange blade creeps forward from the bottom.
Yes, sir. And it just kind
of
creeps
out
the
of the top in an angle. Probably what, maybe a foot and a half long, maybe 2 feet, maybe. Normal blade, like the saber you have is probably 3 feet. So if you want to go off that.
Okay. What's Raz's?
Raz's is probably 48 inches. So
okay,
probably,
cool. So, yeah.
Or maybe
so
even
definitely
five,
shorter than
depending.
His.
It's, I'll
okay,
leave
yeah.
That
so maybe like,
you.
I'd say a foot and a half. Mine's probably about the size of his hilt.
Okay, cool.
Good lord.
Yeah, about a foot and a half.
Hell yeah. Hey, everybody's got their lightsaber turned on. I'm going to hit
awesome.
It. Wow. Wow. Hit the Makashi salute. All
right.
And I do have to go, so.
Perfect. Hey. Perfect timing.
Perfect timing.
Cool.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
So we...
I fucking love it.
Get this changed over.
Our...
Your Padawans.
Yes.
And you are Padawans now.
With this. A voice calls out from the entrance.
Oh?
So, I... See, a new brood has come to my home. I'm very impressed. I hope you found these tools to your liking. And a ghastly blue see-through figure
what the fuck?
Of Avar Chris steps
into the room. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. We got a real Jedi this bitch.
And we will pick up here next week.
Oh, my God. I'm
excited.
Good grinder, guys. That was awesome.
Yeah.
All right, so. All right. Fuck yeah. Jesus. Wasn't expect. Hey, guess what I wasn't expecting for y'all to do today? Build your sabers. So, hey.
Hell yeah.
It works out. Well, I will talk to you guys later.
Yeah,
excellent.
Man, the color just wow.
That went
that's cool.
Well.
I love that. June, a man after my own heart. Incredible.
I love it,
especially with what me and Noah have talked about. I was like, wow.
Yep.
I love it, dude.